Senior day at Franklin Field as well. What a game for the occasion. 5-0 Penn, 4-1 Harvard at 1:30, and here's head coach Al Bagnoli.
We didn't put the mic on purpose, Andy.
I didn't realize that.
That's okay. That's okay. We were coming off of what I thought was going to be a much tougher game than what it ultimately was. It was one of these so-called trap games, after playing Brown for first place, and now have Harvard this week. And I think a couple things saved us. One, it was Princeton, and we played them 103 times, and it was on national TV. So I think we had a much better and a much more emotional effort than maybe what I thought we would have, all things considered. I also thought it was important that we get out of the gate quick, and I think the longer an underdog stays in the game and you give them some confidence and some momentum, the harder the game gets. And that first quarter was about as well as we've played probably since 2002. We scored on our first four possessions touchdowns, scored a field goal on the fifth one, and it was 31-0, just barely into the second quarter, and then things proceeded from there. So obviously we were very pleased with the effort that we got. It's always good to play well against a rival. It's always good to play well on national TV, and I think we come out of that game with increased confidence, especially at the quarterback position, and maybe some of the young guys who had a chance to play quite a bit are a little bit more confident. So we now set our sights on Harvard. Harvard's, as usual, a very talented, terrific, well-balanced team, with two terrific tailbacks, their typical huge offensive line, tight end combination, and just a very, very sound offensive football team. Defensively, they're terrific. Given up 90 yards a game rushing, second in the league in total defense, have forced, they're plus seven in the last 3 weeks in turnovers, and really have two dynamic interior kids in that 4-3 that are just terrific players, probably as good of players as we've seen the entire year. And that's saying a lot when you go back to Villanova and some of the guys that they've had in that interior front. So it'll be a huge challenge for us. Very, very much looking forward to it. This game has taken on great significance the last, probably 10, 15 years. So it should be a lot of fun. I'm glad it's at Franklin Field. Obviously, that's a huge part of it. And, we know we'll have to play well, and we know we'll have to be physical, and hopefully we can, just keep marching along. But it should be a great game against a very, very good football team. So we'll see where it takes us. Questions?
Back to media day, I remember we'd asked you about the fact that Harvard was picked first in the league. Yeah. You said, we'll file that away.
You remembered, huh?
Yeah. Is that a big thing with the kids?
I'm not sure if it is or it isn't. Our kids have a lot of respect for Harvard. they've been a good program. We've been a good program. It falls in week 9. So it's always had implications late in the year. Our kids will be fired up. Their kids will be fired up. And if you want to throw one more thing on top of it, we can, which we probably will. but I'm not sure if we didn't say a word, it wouldn't really matter. It's not like I just may later in the week. Yeah, just that's a good memory you have. That's good. Yeah, John.
A thing or two about playing multiple quarterbacks. How do you prepare for Collier Winters versus Andrew Hatch?
I kind of do the same thing with both. I'm not sure. We haven't seen Hatch play in the last couple of weeks, so I know he had multiple concussions this year, so I'm not sure what his availability is. But they kind of do the same thing. They're just two different body types. Hatch is 6'3 and about 215, and Winters is probably 5'10 and about 185. So kind of doing the same thing. Want to be balanced. Want to establish a little bit of a run game. Want to try to get the quarterbacks out on the perimeter, and want to try to throw some, vertical games. So they're kind of doing the same thing. It's just who's actually at the helm. Okay, thanks.